Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I want to talk to you briefly about three types of fast. Three types. Now, I'm sure you're like, there's only three types of fast. I hear about intermittent fast, I hear about water fasting, I hear about juice fasting. Well, all of those different fasts fall into three main categories, and I'm going to talk to you about them. And when we do our three-day fast, you can choose whatever fast you would like. And at the end of this video, I'm going to talk to you about the fast that I'm probably going to be doing most likely during our three-day fast together. So the first type of fast is called a total fast, and a total fast is when you don't drink any liquids or any food. So no water, no food. So you just go dry, completely dry. And you go for as long as you feel like you are called to. There are some people who practice dry fasting for therapeutic reasons all the time. As a matter of fact, probably the deepest healing, physical healing that you could ever get is by doing a dry fast, but I do not recommend you doing long periods of dry fasting unless you feel like you are called by God to do a long-term dry fast, because it's very cleansing on the body and very hard on the body, because it is using your tissues and your deep water reserves to hydrate and sustain life. So it's not a recommended fast unless you feel like you've been called to it, or some people practice building up to it. So they might dry fast from the time they go to bed to lunchtime, or from the time they go to bed to dinner time, until they can make it for 24 hours. So from dinner time to dinner time, they might dry fast 24 hours. And there are people who are working on practicing dry fasting for 1, 2, 3, 7 days. And in the Bible, Moses did dry fast. He didn't have water or food when he went up on the mountain to get the Ten Commandments. So it is a common fast in the Bible. And most of the time when they're talking about when there are biblical fasts, most of the time they're talking about no water and no food. Some of you are familiar with Esther. She had herself and her maids fast for 3 days with no water and no food. So that's a total fast. So the second type of fast that I want to talk to you about is something called an absolute fast. And what this fast is essentially is a water fast. So if you want to do an absolute fast, you would be on a water fast. And you can drink as much water as you would like. The way that would work is when you would normally eat breakfast, you make sure you drink a good amount of water. When you normally eat lunch, you drink a good amount of water. And when you eat dinner, you drink a good amount of water. That could be a liter or two of water. Or you can just drink water all day. However it's going to work for you. That is an absolute fast. So the third and final type of fast is called a partial fast. Not many people want to call what I'm about to tell you a partial fast, but it's what it is. It's the technical name for it. So when you do things like go on juice fast, or you eat one meal a day, or you will drink herbal teas with honey in it for your fast, or eat a Daniel diet for a fast. Those are all called partial fasts because you are not eliminating calories from your diet during the time you are fasting. So which one of these fasts are going to yield the best results? Well, let me just say this. When you're fasting and praying, it's a matter of the heart. It's not about which fast you do. Unless God has called you to do a specific fast. So for example, if he told you to do a 40-day water fast and you decide to do a 40-day juice fast, well, I'm not saying you won't get any benefits from fasting and praying and doing a juice fast, because you will. But what'll happen is you'll never get around having to do the water fast. Eventually, you will need to do that water fast because that is the thing he is calling you to do. And that has been the case for me for many years. There have been different fasts that the Lord has called me to, and I have done some of the fasting that he has told me to do, and there are others where I just didn't have enough faith to believe that he actually was calling me to that particular fast. So I would do what I thought I could do, and I would complete the fast, but it wasn't what God was actually calling me to. So if you're going on this fast, this three-day fast with us, and you know God is telling you to do a three-day water fast, do the three-day water fast. If you don't know what God is calling you to do, but you feel like he's telling you to fast, then do the fast that you feel like you want to do and follow through with it. But ultimately, the fast that you do really is about the condition of your heart. Where's your heart? Are you fasting unto the Lord? Instead of eating that meal that you normally would eat, are you drinking the juice or are you drinking the water and praying during that time you would be normally eating? So during the live Q&A that I'm going to be doing on July 7th, I'll be talking in a little bit more details about how to fast unto the Lord and how it's going to look for the fasting for the 3 days of the fasting and prayer workshop that we're going to be doing. And really during the workshop, what we're really going to be doing is doing an activation, which is to actually fast and pray. And I'll show you how I fast and pray during that time. So even though it's the 3 days of fasting, there is a teaching session that will happen the day before the actual three-day fast, so you know exactly what to expect. But I just wanted to share this video with you just to give you some ideas of what the differences between fasting are. And you can do whatever kind of fast you want. You can skip breakfast and lunch and eat dinner. You can water fast. You can juice fast. You can dry fast, meaning no water and no food. You can do whatever fast you feel that is the fast that either is ringing in your heart or you're hearing God speak to you and telling you to do. And your fast doesn't even have to be 3 days. I'm actually thinking about creating a group of people who can support each other during the fast if they want to fast longer. Because even though fasting can be is a very private thing, sometimes whenever you're starting to learn how to fast, or if you have been a person who has tried and failed and tried and failed and tried and failed, and I've had my share of that, knowing I was called to fast, starting the fast, and not being able to finish it because of who knows what reason. It could be life. It could be I let food take over. I mean, it could be any reason. And it would be helpful to have like a group of people that can interact with people maybe on Facebook and, you know, tell of some of the struggles that they're having. Maybe I'll come in and pray. I'm not really sure like how I can work that out. If you guys are interested in something like that, let me know in the comments below, because I've actually been toying with I was praying one day and I felt like the Lord was speaking to my heart to create a coaching program where people could practice fasting and praying and get support. And that's more like a corporate fast, but I'm trying to see how that could work out, because I do feel like the Lord dropped it in my spirit one day when I was praying, not only just in general, but I was praying about this 3 day fasting and prayer workshop. I felt like the Lord was saying, no, it's not just 3 days, but create something where people can continue. Because we have so many things in this world today, especially with social media coming at us and distracting us from what it is that God's called us to do, especially in fasting and praying, because food has such a hold on people in general, that creating something where people can come and feel safe and get prayer and also get support and learn more and grow deeper in the discipline of fasting and praying. And a lot of people do everything else that God tells them to do, but they skip the fasting and praying part because they're afraid or they don't know what to do if they'll be without food, and they'll do things like fast Facebook or fast, you know, going to McDonald's or whatever they fast. But like, I think with withholding food, and that's the only representative that I know of in the Bible is withholding food for fasting. Like, really, I don't know of anything else. I'm not saying it didn't happen, but if you've got trouble in your life, whether it is these fibroids, the PCOS, infertility, you've got some life controlling problem, like you can't stop smoking weed and you want to stop smoking weed. You know God is telling you to stop, but you can't stop, or you can't stop lying and you know God's telling you to stop lying. You can't stop spending your money. You're not being a good steward of your money. Like any kind of life controlling problem, I believe that sometimes those kinds of deep rooted sins and life controlling problems don't go away unless we fast and pray. So if you're interested in joining a group where you can go further and get support from me with fasting and praying, please, you know, let me know, because I'll be glad to create that. I really feel like I already heard the Lord tell me to do it. It just depends. I'm going to keep on praying about it and see what I actually hear. And this, even though the subject matter that I'm going to be praying for during this 3-day fasting and prayer that we're going to be doing is going to be for women's health, anything, any issue that you need to bring before the Lord, we can pray for it. So, but that's it. That's all I wanted to say. But I just wanted to talk to you about like the types of fast, because when I talk to people about fasting, and this is my book that I love again. I told you guys about, I love this book. It's a good book. It's in my Amazon store that is linked below. So if you go look in under my book section in the Amazon store, you can find the right book. But when I hear about people fasting and praying, people really don't know how to fast and pray. And I'm going to give you, before the fasting and praying, I think it's going to be on that Sunday. It's just going to be like a little cheat sheet, just with some instructions on, basic instructions on how to fast and pray, and things like that. The other thing that I want to tell you guys too is, this is a stretch for me to get on camera and tell y'all that I am going to pray with y'all. It's a stretch. It's not that I don't pray, because I am a prayer warrior. That is what I do. I've been doing that for the last 20 years. Of course, there have been times in the last 20 years where I've had my dry seasons, and then there are times that like I have more prayer than I ever felt like I ever had in my whole life. And I think it depends on what's going on and what the Lord is speaking to my heart at the time. But the reality is to get up in front of thousands of people on YouTube and pray, this is a bit, it's a bit of a stretch, because it's like I'm putting myself out there. So if you do not join the program, you will not have access to the videos for the 3 days of praying. So if you want to have access to the 3 days of praying, you need to click the link in the description box that says, do you want to be a part of the fasting and praying workshop? And if you do, you put your name and email address in there, and when it's time for the prayer time, you will be able to click the link and see the actual videos. They will not be public on my YouTube channel. You'll see it on YouTube, but they won't be public. So that's one thing that I wanted to share with you. And also, I'm going to put this out there too. Most of my praying I do in the spirit, in tongues. I pray in tongues. That is what my life is. That's how I pray. And so I've been praying and asking God how that's going to look, because I know that I have people from all walks of life who watch my videos, who have signed up for this prayer and fasting workshop. Some of y'all don't believe in praying in tongues. Some of y'all think it's from the devil. Some of y'all got all kinds of thoughts about it. And I don't know how God's going to work that out. So there, and if that offends you, that might be something that you need to pray about if you want to be a part of this, this prayer and fasting section. So I just wanted to talk to you all about that. I don't know if it was necessary. All I know is that a move of God is coming for these women, the women that are at this in the sound of my voice, that have been struggling for years. They've been trying to do the right thing with their bodies, and they haven't been able to do it for whatever reason. And I believe God is healing people, because he has heard the cry of the women who are struggling. But the other thing I want to tell you is you cannot sit there and pray and pray and pray and pray and do nothing else to change your lifestyle. If you think for one second that you can sit there and pray and still be sitting there shoving chicken wings in your mouth and French fries in your mouth and hamburgers in your mouth and not doing anything to help yourself to get well, then you got another thing coming. Because why is it, are you going, why would God actually, how can God actually heal your body and make it work like the well-oiled machine it was created to work, but you continue to put garbage in it? So some of y'all believe you don't have to change your diet. You don't have to take care of yourself. And unfortunately, that is just not the case. We, just like he says, we're supposed to be a good steward over our money. We have to be a good steward over our bodies, because our body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. And I know some of you are struggling with being a good steward of your body. And that is what I teach. I teach women how to be a good steward over their bodies and put premium gasoline in their bodies so that their bodies will work in the perfection in which God created them to work. So I just wanted to say that. And I think that's about it, y'all. I'm done talking. And until next week, we'll see you later. Take care.